Welcome back to Let's Play Amberstar. I'm Amethyst Lunatari. We found our way out of that situation we were in. For those who, well, didn't watch the last two episodes, and or may have forgotten, Amethyst was turned to stone, thus we could not access her inventory and use the flute to escape this area. There's a tire. Well, I'm not gonna see because it's nighttime is approaching, but just take my word for it. We're in the middle of a ring of mountains, and the only way out that I know of is to call the giant eagle with that flute. So we had no way to unpetrify her. She doesn't even have, I mean, I'm guessing there is a spell at some point. I'm not even sure. She doesn't have a spell to remove a petrification or stone to flesh, that kind of thing. I mean, I'm not sure how you'd even cast it because, well, I guess it would have to be outside of battle, because once the character is turned to stone, they're not even, you know, among the characters on the tactical grid. They're not even there to, you know, target a spell. So, or potion, herb, what have you. So, yeah, there's no potion or herb that does that. So, had to play that part over again, fight the, all the rats with the shadow, and, the second time the shadow, turned silk to stone, petrified him, and then right after that, he cast a madness on Trazeric. Silk was the only one who had. We ended up using it on somebody else. It's a blue flower. Silk was the only one who had the one herb we had to turn someone sane, I suppose. Sorry about that. And so yeah, that was fun. So I had to play it over again. Yeah, the blue flowers. Only Silk had the herb. So after having fought that battle twice, and then on the way out, I fought those I forget what it was, 8 or 10 rats with 2 spiders thrown in the middle. That was a lot of fun. We had everyone at some point either turned ill or were poisoned. So Amethyst was kept quite busy. She became ill, cast what is it? Cure sickness? Heal sickness on herself. And then immediately the round thereafter, she became ill again. It was a lot of fun. Anyway, so here we have not. We found a way out, so. Oh, and I went back and actually fought those 3 swamp spiders that were trailing us. I fled from them the first time just trying to find a way out and could not find any, so I went back this time and fought and killed them. So let's put this stuff on because I don't know what lay ahead, and we might need to fight. What we definitely need to do is see. So we're gonna end up dropping down. What I'm curious about, oh, is she gonna be able to cast that? Well, we have an item. We have this, which, by the way, she's the one who can cast levitation, so why don't we give this to somebody who can't do it naturally? Well, can anyone use this item? I think it's a specialty item that anyone can use, right? Let's just take a peek. Oh, he's full of stuff now. Yeah, anyone can use it. Alright. 25 uses of levitation. Can she What she stands for. Okay. Now we have levitation on. There's no indicator here. But can we still fall? Evidently not. But do we want to levitate right there? Because there's an area we want to get to. Oh, we're not going to fall? Alright, so we don't levitate no matter what. I mean, we don't fall no matter what. That's kind of like pokes a hole in my plan. So, alternatively, we could run back here. See, I restored for where... Yeah, we don't have levitation on. We gotta find a way into that area. That's probably where the Dwarven Crown is. On level 2? No. Yeah, 2, I believe. Alright, so down. And then... This is where we want to go, so I figured we'd fall down, and I checked all these walls. There's no illusory walls. I figured we'd fall down here. Well, then we have to go to the then we have to go to the bottom floor to get to this area. Right in the middle, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Right, do we have to count this? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. So it's 11 east, and what did I say? 6? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I'm guessing you fell here or here. 11 east, 5 north. That's just the way I'm doing it. That's probably not proper map notation, but you know, it's my own way of figuring out where we're supposed to be, because I don't know if you can see it that easily from the ceiling there. Because you remember we dropped down to level 3, so we were heading the other way. So now we're heading back. Doubling back to the third floor. So I guess we could have hit this the whole time, but we would have fell again anyway? I'm not sure. I never did try levitate. I thought of it, but I'm figuring we fell down 2 floors. So what's the point, right? So... So we want to hit from here? Alright, right, it's a... okay. The only way back there... because we fell all the way down here... the only way back there now, since we can't fall through that hole in the first floor, or second floor apparently... is to hit this, which teleports us here, so we have to go all the way around. Thank you. So now we are here. So it put us right at the mouth of this thing. There is the trapdoor. Okay. So now we hit our levitate. Sweet. Okay. Once more to unexplored territory. Exciting! Sorry, it took me 15 minutes just to get here. Which way to go? Which way? Let's go through the wooden door first. Huh. Well, we've got a chest. Trap found. Trap disarmed. Lock opened. In the chest lies a velvet cushion on which rests a sparkling crown. A large piece of the Amberstar has been set into the front of the crown. Despite your efforts, you do not succeed in prizing the piece of the Amberstar from it, so you have to take the whole crown with you. That's fine, because Donner wants the crown, and he will pry the Amberstar out of it for us. Dwarf crown. Oh, it's a shield. Oh, we can wear this thing? That's pretty cool. Of course, you can't wear it indefinitely because you can't finish the game without all the pieces of the Amberstar. Anyone not wearing a head item? Oh, that's not what I want to do. He's wearing a helmet, but I'm sure the crown is more than Shield of Six. This is a Shield of One. I keep hitting the wrong thing. Shield of One, okay. How about we identify this thing, actually? Hope it works right the first time. Alright, 10 shield. No special attributes, okay. My Trasric is wearing the Dwarf Crown. Not gonna be very useful to him. Because he's in the bottom row, and I don't know if shield affects against, like, spell effects and stuff. We really haven't encountered many people throwing range weapons at us, just spell effects. So we came from here, and we want to go here, I believe. Yeah. So since we got the crown, let's save, in case we run into something terrible. I can't see much from there. Just mapping it out. Oop, I hate that. Back up. I don't see anything down there. This is a dead end here. What's this? Another chest. What's around the other corner? Another chest. Okay, no enemies. Sweet. Alright, Silk, do your thing. Okay, didn't need to unlock it. In the chest you find gold and a coat of mail armor. 546 gold. Thank you. Mithril mail! I want... about Satine, hold it. Wear it, actually. Because mithril mail can be used by anybody. Or worn, donned, whatever. By anybody. Shield of 12. So watch her armor class go from 12 to 22. Sweet. And she's just about full of stuff. Alright, let's actually give this to somebody else. Let's let Silk hold on to it. That was worth it. So now we just need... because... the merchant... the only other place I've seen this is the merchant in Gemstone, and he was selling two, I believe, or one? I think it was just one. Now the reason I'm holding is because 162 versus 106, I have a lot more hit points to absorb damage. So the next mithril mail will probably be mine. Gribban did have it. We got him plate mail and passed the mithril mail to Trasrek. Now Satine has some mithril mail and Drobanir has plate. So next will be Amethyst and then Silk for wearing mithril mail. Hopefully we find two more and my life will be complete. Alright, what we got in here? This one is locked. Trap found. Disarmed. In the chest you find gold and a few gems. 859 gold. Before we... who's holding the gems? Droba? Yes. Alright, we'll give him the gems because they stack. And then we'll collect the gold. Good. Done. And that's it. We are on the second floor. But we're in a locked-in area. So we're going to have to fall back down the pit. And then work our way from level 3. Just back the way we were with the chest. Yeah, we need to fall down to go back up. You fall through the trapdoor and land abruptly on the cold stone floor further down. Ouch! You know we have rope, though. But I think they would have used up the rope, so whatever. Can we use rope to go up? I'm just going to save over because we'll just find a way up the old-fashioned way if it doesn't work. I don't think it would because it would only go up one, right? I think rope only helps you travel down. Okay, so you can use the rope to go up. There's that also. Good to know. But it doesn't help us. So to get back, we have to go around. We're on through. This is the level we start on. Well, third level. No, this is all the way down the bottom. Never mind. I'm getting confused. I just want to get that blip. So we are here. And we need to make our way all the way back up. Out. Alright, can I call the eagle from here? I'm guessing I have to be out of here. Yeah, I didn't think so. Quite an ordeal. Yes! Get us away from this accursed place. Heading back to Donner's Mine, which is roughly this way. I'm glad I finished that dungeon. That's an interesting little grove there. Okay, we're at a swamp. This is probably the swamp station here. Should I take a look over here? It might not be. No, it's just a random small swamp by the water. Is this the ocean? This has to be the ocean, okay. I know exactly where we are then. The swamp station is actually further up this way. You want to take a look at it. It's probably a bit here. Oh, look at that. There's a little house. Just gotta know what the swamp station itself is. Should I bother messing with this right now? Curiosity. This house is in a very sorry state. There is dirt and rubbish everywhere, but apparently the house is not deserted because all the candles and torches are lit and are burning merrily. I don't think we have everything we need to get through this area. Well, we can take a look at the guardhouse. We got something here. In this chest, you find a few tar torches, a jewel, and a crowbar. I think I'll leave the crowbar. A topaz, okay. Do we have, like, one or two crowbars? I have one. I don't think you need more than one. I'm gonna leave it here. We'll probably need it, you know, for this area. So just in case something happens to the crowbar we have. It's here for us. Nothing here. Oh, somebody here as well. Books. I don't want to go to sleep. Who are you? My eyes are very feeble, so move closer to the light. Yes, that's better. What do you want here? Work on the plant stopped many years ago after a large part of the channel collapsed and our leader was killed. Do you want to go into the sewers? If so, I must advise you to be careful. The roof is quite unsafe, and these sewer rats are dangerous, really dangerous. Anyway, you can't get into the sewer if you don't know the password. What was it anyway? I'm sorry, but with the best will in the world, I simply cannot remember. Think you better get a better will, then. Well, I can't, like, talk to this person, actually. Okay. On the ladder in front of you hangs an old dusty sign showing in red letters, "Warning: Risk of collapse. Enter at your own will." Enter at your own risk. Still thinking about a lady's will. Okay, so this is the actual ladder down. Swampstation channels. Well, I look forward to exploring this, but not just yet. Because we have two other places to go. We have to go to the House of Donner, inside Donner's mine. Well, she had to sit down. Away from the swamp. Oh. Oh, we're in battle. Okay, we're in battle. That's fine. We fought plenty of these things before. I don't have protections on, I guess not, but do we need them? I'll throw an ice ball, why the hell not? These swamp rats. Shouldn't be too difficult at all. We need to get these guys some, sling stones and arrows. Grab on poisoned. I'm gonna finish it off, so I'll heal his poison after out of combat, which is now. I got 23 experience here. Neutralize. There we go. Alright, let's call our bird.